Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to speak about the Erin Condren Focused Collection. This collection is targeted more towards people who are interested in neutral, simple and minimalistic styles in their stationery. Personally, I use both. By both, I mean I use the Focused Collection for work and the other colorful Erin Condren products for home use. Now, it is all a matter of choice or preference. Some people might like using these neutral products at home. So it's up to whether you like it or not. It is not about whether you're a man or a woman. So it is not specific to some people as such. Now coming to the collection, this is probably my favorite line in the Erin Condren collection. They have several products listed on the site under the Erin Condren Focused Collection, which includes desk accessories, sticky pockets, ruler, but I would say they are general products which are otherwise also there on the Erin Condren site. These notebooks and planners are the main things that are specifically under the Focused Collection because they are more neutral compared to the other products. Now coming to the notebooks and planners. Both are available in softbound options as well as coiled hardbound options. Now, the notebooks I won't be discussing in detail now because I've already spoken about them in a previous video. You can go and check out my video for that, which is where I speak all about Erin Condren notebooks, all of their notebooks. But I do have a few here, so I'll just go through them quickly. As you can see, this is the hardbound. This is the only coiled as well as the only hardbound format available for them in the Focused Collection. And this is the exact way the planner also looks. This is the notebook, but the planner also basically looks the same thing. And you get a bigger version of the planner, which is dated. Okay, they give it out in the calendar year, January to December. And it is available in the large format, which is 8x10. This is probably my least favorite Erin Condren product, the black hardbound coiled product that they have, because simply it is too heavy and it is too expensive when you look at the amount that they charge for this, and I don't think it is worth the money. It doesn't even look that great, but again, your choice whether you like it or not. Now coming to the softbounds, on the other hand, I love the softbounds. I have to tell, I love the softbounds. They are available in a few colors. Mainly five, I believe. One is this Monaco, the camel, the navy. They have a gray option and also a new one in black. The black one, yes, they also have a black one in softbound. So I'm kind of trying to collect all the colors because I just love this cover that they have. It is vegan leather, which is basically plastic, a nice word for plastic. Anyway, it comes with such a packaging which is also quite neat. They have a neat packaging as well. 124 pages as usual for the notebooks, and neat, like I said. The only problem that I have with the Focused Collection notebooks is, unlike the regular Erin Condren notebooks where you get to choose whether it's a dot grid notebook or a lined notebook, you do not have that option over here. Like, if this one is blank, this cover option is available only in blank. The camel is available only in ruled. And I think the black one is all productivity. The gray is also blank. Navy is probably lined. So basically, I think there is also no dot grid options available. So that is the only limitation that they have here, that they are not giving you a choice to select. So that is a problem. But as usual, you get to customize all the Focused Collection products. So if you want, you can add in your name, but only in blind imprint. But so far, I would say it has worked out well for me. I have already customized these two books in blind imprint and I love it so far, but then it's up to you. I think there is a word limitation because, unlike the other Erin Condren products, the blind imprint is towards the right hand lower corner of the book, so I think it is limited to 4 letters. Okay, that is all you can fit in, I believe. Anyway, that is regarding the Erin Condren notebooks that you see over here. Now coming to the planner, what I love about the Focused Collection is that, other than the dated planners, they also provide undated undated planners are not a part of the regular errand conduit planners, except for the petite planner system. Yes, there they have undated ones. Okay, so what I love is that here you have an option for that. And I've told before, I'm trying to collect all the covers. So even though I like the camel cover which I showed earlier, I decided to go for this instead, just because I'm collecting all the focused collection covers. So this customizable planner is available in two colors. One is navy and the camel option. And you also have two sizes. This is the large one, 8x10. And you also have, you also have an A5. There is also a focused teacher planner available, which is only available in the camel option. And secondly, one thing to notice, they do not provide academic year options. Maybe they will one day. As of now, they do not provide. So let us go to the flip through of the customizable one. As you open it, you come to the page. Here you can write your name. I love what they've done here. Instead of leaving it blank, I like the stripes that they have over here. Once you flip through, you get into the goals and intentions page, and as usual, this does not lie flat because it is the first page. What I like about this is that unlike the regular errand conduit planners, the idea is that this is for the 12 months, but you can use it however you want it. There is nothing mentioned over here, but yes, generally the idea is use it for 12 months. Even this is not too difficult to cover up in case you want to use it for something other than goals and intentions. Now, we directly come to the monthly spread without anything else in between. The monthly spread, as I said, is quite minimalistic, but the exact same spread as you find in the life planners. Only difference is there are no designs or patterns over here. So you have the note section here. The monthly is there with small boxes, so you can write down the date over there. And of course, you have a section over here as well to write down the month, or you can write it wherever you want. It's up to you. So that is the simplistic monthly spread, which starts on a Sunday, ends on a Saturday. Now we move forward. Yes, this is what is completely different about this planner. You do not have a dashboard. Most errand conduit planners have a dashboard for the monthly. Instead, what you have is you seem to be having a dashboard for every weekly spread. Before every weekly spread begins, you have this spread, which is kind of a weekly dashboard, and this is the exact same spread that is available in the Black Productivity book, which they have recently released. Okay, so this is the exact spread in that book, and the same reason why I did not buy the book, because I don't know what to do with this spread. If you have any ideas, please post it down in the comments below, because I'm kind of lost about the spread. And if I'm not mentioned before, I'm using this as a work planner. So anyway, let's just go through the spread. You have week of, okay, I don't know what comes over here. Week of what? Week of June? Okay, my mind is just not working. Anyway, if you know, please put it down in the comments. You have a section here to write down the to-dos. You have checklist here. Then you have a small blank section here. You have a ruled section here, which is divided. So you have three sections. It can be morning, afternoon, evening, or priorities, important, least important, however you want to use it. And on the right hand side, you have an entirely dot grid page. One good thing is, as usual, nothing is written, so you can customize it however you want. So that is the weekly dashboard, which is there before every weekly spread. Now coming to the weekly spread. This is another limitation of the errand conduit focused collection, that it is available only in horizontal. So if you are a vertical planner or a daily planner person, then I don't know how you plan on using this. In fact, I'm a vertical planner. I use an errand conduit softbound life planner, and I do not like the hourly or the horizontal when I think of it in my mind. But I ended up buying this planner because, one, it is the only undated option available, which I wanted for work, an undated option. And secondly, I think I can manage this format for work. Since it is not for my home purposes, I think I can manage it. Now, coming to the spread. Again, you have week off, for which I'm lost still. It starts with a Monday. It's a Monday start. You go all the way to Sunday. You can write the date on the other side. It is ruled on one side, blank on the other side. Some people are bothered by this. I am not bothered by it. I think I can make it work. But yes, they could have gone for completely ruled. And you have a note section here, which has checklist on one side. So here you do not have a checklist. So that is your weekly spread. Another thing, important thing to note over here is that they have provided 5 weekly spreads for every month. Because it is generally around 5 weeks, but the issue is that it is not an issue as such, but just mentioning it. What happens is, suppose for the month of June now, it starts on a Monday, so that is perfect, 1st of June, but it ends the 30th of June on a Tuesday, okay? And generally, what the life planners will do is they continue from here with the next month, so this would be 1st of July. But here, since they have given 5 weekly spreads for every month, I probably will not continue from here. Clearly, I'll be starting the next month, that is July, on the next spread. So this entire page then goes to waste. So that is just one thing to keep in mind. But if you're okay with it, it's not a big deal. So then you again, just after the weekly spread, it is directly the next month. You do not have any notes pages in between, but then again, you don't need one because they have provided so many weekly spreads, weekly dashboard pages between every weekly spread that you don't need extra notes pages in between. So that is how it goes till the end. You have 12 months like that. Of course, you have 2 ribbon bookmarks over here, which are perfect to use. 2 is just perfect. Then as you come to the end of the planner, yes, here you have note pages. Here you have notes pages, which begin with ruled or lined notes pages, which are 10. I counted them. So you have 10 notes pages, which are quite good. It is quite a good number. You have a lot of notes pages here. Then you have dot grid notes pages, which would have been 10. It is a 9 here. Then you have a contact. I don't see the need for this contact page, but then because everyone just has phone numbers on their mobile, and unless you probably add it to an address book. But anyway, they have a contacts here, which I know I'm not going to use. And then we come to the end of the focus planner with a blank side, and again the beautiful stripes here. I added a sticky pocket over here because I always need it. Since it's for work, I'll probably be adding in some paper or something over here. And if you want to add in a notepad, this is the large notepad. It's too much to fit in perfectly, so I wouldn't suggest the large one. Probably the medium sized one, you can get it to fit over here because it's like exact. It won't work. So that is an issue. So in case you want to add in something over there. And did anyone else have this issue with the sticky pockets, or is it just me? Because I always, at least most of the time, I seem to be getting sticky pockets that are both of one size. See, generally it is supposed to be one for the back, one for the front. I tend to get both for the back. I do not get the front one. Not always, most of the times. Like I did a recent order where I ordered 3 of them. So 2 of them were the back ones, both of them were back ones, while one had proper one back and one of the front cover. Or is it just me? I don't know. Anyway, with that we come to the end of our focused collection. You have the Erin Condren logo over here. And this is probably my most favorite from their collection. Please write down in the comments below if you like my video. Please subscribe to it, and your suggestions are always welcome. Happy weekend!